painters and poets, city workers and stay-at-home mums, students and singers, gardeners and golfers, lycra lovers, old and young, from all different nations, backgrounds and situations. We are cities on a hill, instruments in his hands, lights to a fallen world, illuminating the darkness, shining light in every dark place, with the beauty of the gospel. In every mundane moment, when you are surrounded, or when you feel alone, you are never alone. Because the Father is watching, the Spirit is stirring, and the Son is calling us on. Calling us to live for Him. In every dreary commute, in every nappy change, when your tongue is bitten so hard, your teeth nearly go through. In that moment when you held your anger, or chose to forgive rather than to stew. We can feel like ants, seemingly insignificant, but together fulfilling our purpose and building a kingdom. We're called to be stars and supernovas, blazing lights pointing to the Father of all light, beacons of hope, signs all across the suburbs and the city, like billboard posters saying it's all for His glory. We're ambassadors, hope bringers and life givers in every circumstance and situation, because there is meaning in every moment, and every moment has a purpose. We're called to let our light shine, because nothing is meaningless if the motive is Christ, because God has redeemed every part of our lives. So whatever you do, shine.
To enjoy the worship service, the singing, and the preaching. So come on in and take a seat and enjoy the service.
Biggest place of praise. We welcome you to Lighthouse Ministries. We thank you for joining us this morning. We pray that you like, share, and come in this worship experience. That God is in the midst of this place. If you know that the Lord is good, we want you to lift up in this place. A praise that will erupt your atmosphere. Come on. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, do a good thing. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. Let me call him a doctor. She loves me. And when you begin to call upon his name. And we stretch hand out of bed. There's something about when we lay crawling in bed and call him. More, amen, to the nitty-gritty, amen, of God's word.
That's right. Amen. I want to know, amen, what, Lord, what are you trying to tell me here, amen? And then he, amen, we talk about Peter, amen, today, amen. As we, amen, talk to, amen, Peter, amen, we know him as an apostle of Jesus Christ. Some people call him Saint Peter, amen. Simon Peter, amen. I mean, most people know him of, and amen, one of the disciples of Jesus. And along with James and John, he was Jesus' closest companion. You know, he's going to do something, he's going to pray, or he's going to a certain spot, amen. He take, amen, Peter, James, and John. Amen. He was a fisherman by trade. Amen. And he was known, amen, to, amen, to, amen, speak his mind. Amen. We know that, amen, that, amen, he always, amen, we out front, amen, and say what others were thinking. Amen. People were known as speaking mind. He was a writer of the gospel. Amen. You know, amen, one of the things, amen, some, amen, thing we always, amen, you know what they call, like, amen, one-liners, amen, and, amen, you are the Christ. Amen. And, you know, Matthew 16 and 16, Peter said that. You are the Christ, Son of the what? The living God. And Luke, amen, 22 and 34, he said, then, you know, this one, amen, you know that they talk about Peter, when Jesus told him, he said, I tell you this, Peter, before the, amen, the rooster crow three times, amen, you're going to deny it. But when he got saved, and he got converted, amen, and the Lord told him, when you converted, amen, scripture your brother, amen, when he got saved and filled with the Holy Ghost, Lord have mercy. You go and ask one and two and one, amen. 3,000 souls, amen, got saved. Lord have mercy, amen. He was preaching the gospel. Amen. When he began to preach the gospel, amen, he became a bold soldier, amen, for the Lord.
Yes, he did.
Amen. And we see, amen, and we talking about Peter, amen. He began to tell us something this morning. Amen. When he's telling us, amen, as I begin to, amen, think about him, the Lord, amen, began to, amen, speak to me in a dream. He said, hold it together.
Hold it together. Okay. Hold
amen. He let him know, amen, you got to be alert. Yeah. Amen. Be sober. Amen. Amen. If you're sober, amen, you're not drunk. You got a clear, amen. You got a clear head. You clear head.
Yeah.
You're not intoxicated. You're not intoxicated. Amen. You're sober minded.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He wants us to be sober. Because anybody, amen, that don't have a clear head, amen, they ain't thinking straight.
All
amen.
Right.
You ain't sober, amen. I mean, you're intoxicated, amen. You wallowing from side to side, amen. You're not aware, amen, what's going on. So saints, he wants to be alert.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Not want to be sober minded, because you're sober minded, you can think clear.
Amen.
But he wants us to be vigilant.
Yes.
Meaning be alert. Vigilant means be watchful.
Okay.
Amen. What he want you to be watchful for? Amen. Because he know, amen, that your adversary, the devil, amen, he walking around y'all, trying to find somebody, amen, he can devour. Amen. So he said, amen, be vigilant.
Mm-hmm.
So church, amen, we got to hold it together. You cannot, amen, say, well, amen, be complacent. Amen. You got to, amen, hold it together. Amen. You got to, amen, have a sharp eye.
Yes.
A saint should have a sharp eye.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Eyes shouldn't be clouded. Your eyes clouded. Amen. You didn't have the Lord, amen, give you a spiritual eye. Amen. Ask him, amen, to clear up your sin, amen, the way you see.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And when you vision, amen, you don't always, amen, amen. So you're going to bow towards the watch and pray. So you got to be vigilant, amen, of what's going on around you. I mean, you got to see, amen, the thing that's going on. This pandemic ain't just happened to be, amen, it's here for a reason.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. That same God, amen, allowed, amen, the same God can, amen, take it away.
Yeah, amen.
So we must do something, amen, amen. We must call the Lord, help us.
Yeah.
So say, hold it together.
Yeah.
You got to be watchful in this last and evil day. You can't be asleep, amen, amen, amen. If you're asleep, amen, the devil, amen, is walking around.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Amen. He's walking around trying to see who he can devour.
Yes.
Amen, amen. He tells, amen, to resist him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. If he don't divide me, when he hear that, amen, that means he home. Amen. The devil, amen, didn't know that he home, amen. And that definition means, amen, eat, amen, hungry, amen, he eat quickly. So I guess why the Bible told us they move quickly. Because what? He said that the definition means, devour means to eat quickly. Amen. You're a lion. You ain't got time to be wasting around over food, amen, because the coyote gonna come and try to, amen, to eat, take it away from you. Amen. So not only that, he's, amen, they say he greedy. Amen. I said, what you say? I said, look at this here, Lord. I said, definition what devour means, he greedy. Mm-hmm. Amen. So what? He ain't gonna stop it, because you told him, get behind me, Satan, amen. He gonna leave, amen. Go to somebody else. I see what? He's greedy.
Yes. All right.
Lord, I told you, amen. I understand.
I see.
What you say, amen? Thank you, Holy Ghost. Amen. He's been working on me. Amen. Yes. Glory. Amen. Amen. So devour me, amen. Amen. So he greedy, amen. So he trying to devour every saint. Man, we ain't got to worry about nobody he already got, because he already got them.
Yes.
But if you trying to live right, amen, the devil trying to devour you. He trying to tear you asunder. Amen. He trying, amen. The Bible say he's like a roaring lion.
Yeah.
He say he is, amen. He say he like a roaring lion. You know what I'm saying? Amen. My neighbor got a dog, amen. He a rat dog. Amen. Ugly looking, black, long pointed heels, amen. And he bought his bark is like he gonna do something. Man, so I went over there one day. He got his leg tangled up, and Lord, he couldn't get out. Lord, have mercy. Amen. You know what he did? He said, "Ready, I tell you, got his leg out." Then he started back up again. His bark, amen, is louder than him, amen. But he, amen. But he was hurt that day. I know the tone with him. He just said, "Anybody suggest give me some relief on my leg, amen." He got wrapped up and tied up in there. So I helped him get out. So as soon as he got out, he started back up again like he was the baddest thing on the block. He like a roaring lion. Amen. He like a roaring lion. The Bible says he's not a roaring lion, but he like.
Yes, yes.
Amen. He's here to fool you.
Uh-huh.
Like he got all power. Mm. Amen. This is what he tried to do, Jesus. Amen. After the fast, amen. And when God is blessing you and doing good things in your life, the devil ain't for a bad. You better begin to pray. Because he's going to try you, amen. He's going to throw something in there, amen. He tried Jesus.
Yes, he did.
Jesus, amen, had fasted, amen. He came and gave himself a thing, but he told him, get you behind me, Satan. Because everything, amen, Jesus said was the word. So how are you going to defeat the devil if you don't have the word?
Amen. Amen.
Jesus told us how to defeat the devil. He used the word.
Yes.
When nothing that he was saying that wasn't written down in the word.
Yes.
Everything that he said, man should not live by bread alone, was in the word.
In the word. Yes.
So the only way you're going to defeat him, amen, is through the word.
The word. Yes.
He told us to, amen, resist him. Amen, resist, amen, to... Amen. You gonna, amen, withstand. You gonna hold against. Amen. You gonna hold your ground. Amen. You gonna weather the storm. Resist him. Stand firm in the faith. Amen. To believe, amen, that God, amen, gonna bring you out. Amen. Amen. James, amen, 4:7 says, amen, talks about, amen, resist the devil. He will flee from you. Flee means run, y'all. Man, he gonna, amen, he gonna make a run, amen, he gonna run for it. Because what? You using the power of the Lord upon him, amen, he can't stand.
Yeah.
Amen, the only way you gonna defeat him, amen, is through the word.
Yeah.
That word, amen, you got to hear in your heart that you might not, what, sin against him.
Yeah.
Amen, he come, amen, that, amen, to try to hinder us. Amen, but we must hold it together. We must, amen, amen, keep the course. If you don't keep the course, amen, you're going to be lost. Amen, you out there in your home trying to figure, amen, how you'll get back to your normal routine, amen, but not going to church, not serving him. You know, every this week, amen, this come to me this week. Spirit said now, how if you don't shorten the days? Amen, and how the gospel is going to be, amen, how it's going to be sent out. And you know, this pandemic might be one of those things, amen, call for the gospel. There were more people. I got more people online, amen, that I probably would have never got, amen, to check us out. That means what? Somebody was sitting at home, amen, one morning, nobody in church, keen in to see what thus says the Lord.
Amen.
Before this thing in, everybody got to hear about, amen, the Lord. And I believe it's there now. Because this internet, amen, let us know, amen, we can find out, amen, something about, amen, the goodness of the Lord.
Yes.
We can find out somebody, amen, you can turn on, and somebody, amen, amen, preaching and teaching about, amen, amen, Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God. So we must hold on.
Oh, yeah.
The devil, amen, trying to destroy us. Amen, he trying to, amen, do us in. He trying to have us to throw it in the towel. But, amen, he give us something, amen, to help us. Amen, and so, amen, so Ephesians 6 and 12, amen, help us, amen, in this area, amen, of when we wrestling against.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How we come short, amen. How we, amen, falling through the hole, amen. How we, amen, should hold it together and not throw in the towel, y'all. He said, we wrestle not.
Yeah.
Get flesh and blood.
Yeah.
Against principalities and powers and against rulers and doctors of this world. Against spiritual wickedness in what? High places.
Yeah.
So he let them know, amen, this is not just a, amen, a natural thing. Amen, this is spiritual thing. We got spiritual warfare going on. But he let us know, y'all, what we must do. We must put on the whole armor of God.
Yeah.
Hey, glory. Put on the whole armor of God.
Oh, God.
Yeah. That we must be able, when he come, amen. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. When the devil come, you may need to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Yeah.
This is the word, y'all.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Take the word to save it, or take the word to keep. Yeah. He told us to put on the breastplate of righteousness.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Amen. Amen, amen. Not only he told us to shield our feet with the gospel of peace. Amen. Shield your faith. Amen, amen. He let us put on the helmet of salvation.
Yes, yes.
Glory to God. So what will we do? We must hold it together.
Hold it together.
You know, we, amen, so many people, amen, now, amen, throwing in the towel. So many people got other things to do, amen, than serving the Lord. Amen. So many people, amen, trying, amen, to, amen, amen, not, amen, call them on their name. And on your job, the people know you're saved. Hold it together, saints. The devil trying to, amen, he know, amen, how to, amen, trick us, amen, because one thing he do, amen, he stop us from praying. Because you know if you pray, amen, you'll get a breath. He stop us from trusting in God, amen. Because you know, amen, if you don't trust him, amen, you won't rely on him.
Amen.
Amen. He don't want us to stick together. Mm-hmm. Amen. Stick together, amen. I want to say stick together like I'm going to do. Amen. Stick together like glue.
All
right. Amen. He don't want, amen, us to, amen, stick together. Mm-hmm. Amen. He don't want, amen, family units. Don't care what he embarrassed you.
Amen.
So you shouldn't be embarrassed to call him out. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Call him out.
Yes.
That son you have, amen. That called you from, call him out.
Yes.
You tell him, amen, I'm gonna put you in the name of the Lord. That daughter, amen, don't seem she can't get herself together. Call her out.
Yes.
Amen. Don't be out.
Yes, Lord.
Hold your family together. Stick to like glue. That glue is the prayer, amen, to hold the family together. We pray together. When you pray together, you'll stay together.
All right.
Pray together, amen. Amen. Hold hands, amen, with each other.
Yes.
Tell me we're going to have a family prayer. And maybe you might be the only one, amen, that's the one trying to live safe. Well, you lead the prayer. Amen. Your husband might not be doing it. Your children may not be doing it. But you hold it together. You invite them over to eat. So we come to eat, y'all. I want you to know you can get folk by eating. Amen. You draw more fly with honey. Amen. Food that don't cook today. Y'all come on. And when you get together, amen, you quote your scripture. You pray it right there. And you lay hands on all of them. Say, you ain't come to church today, man. So I'm going to anoint you with all to pray for. You they ain't already today. Amen. Maybe you might need to pray for the email.
Yeah, you
know what I'm saying? Pray, amen, for you. And so I mean, amen, pray for you.
Oh, that's right.
Amen. That's why I said pray for you. Amen. Pray. Amen. Amen. Get them there, amen. Anoint hands on and pray for them. Some of them have a problem. Amen. You dealt with don't like marriages. Amen. You can be a couple doing all the things that married folk do and think like everything worked good. Anytime you say you gonna get married, amen, the devil, amen, he's standing right there. Seems like he get in there, he can't never get out. But we got to pray, amen. The glue is to pray. You got to keep, amen, the prayer. You got to hold it together.
Oh,
yeah. Hold it together. And you know what? Amen. Though they've been married a long time, amen, you say, oh, that's a blessing. You know what? Marriage is work.
Yes, it is.
Amen. It ain't always easy to bed of roses all the time. Amen. Don't run away from it. Hold it together. Amen. Amen. You are bought with a price. You're free. If you're free, and say, Lord, you say I'm free indeed. Amen. So what? Amen. That other part of that verse that cast your cares upon him because what? He cares for you.
Yes.
Cast your cares upon him.
Okay.
And I'll leave you with this quote.
Okay.
I just want to talk to you today, amen. I already, amen, and expound a little bit, amen. But we just want to talk to you, amen, because the Lord said, talk to me this morning.
Yes.
Amen. This quote, amen. Amen. I didn't get it first. I had to read it several times. So you might have to go read it several times. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Maybe, amen. You might not be amen. Amen. Like you may ain't as keen all the time. Amen. So I had to go look up. Amen. Look up words and say amen. And see how he brought that together. Pastor Jeremiah said a quote. He said, there is no shortcut to character and no detour around difficulty. I say that again, there's no shortcut in character and no detour around difficulty.
Yes.
So no matter what you do, amen, some things gonna come your way.
Yes.
That's just what the devil do. Amen, he come quickly, he try to get you, amen, when your mind is not focusing on the Lord. He try to get you and mess you up, amen, and turn you around. Amen. Get you focused on other things and focusing on what you need to be doing and praying and seeking God. Amen. His word, amen. The word is what you use, amen, to defeat the devil with. His word gonna shine forever. But heaven and earth gonna pass away. So you must, amen, seek God, amen, with your whole heart.
Yes.
Without him, you can't do nothing.
Amen.
You can't make it by yourself.
Amen.
Amen. Come, amen. But with the Lord, amen, you got power. With the Lord, amen, you can make it.
Oh, yes.
If you try. Amen. Just say, Lord, amen, I'm trusting in you. And as we begin to pray today, so Lord, we thank you. As we stand here, Lord, in their homes, amen, those that, amen, maybe, amen, on that bed of affliction, they call us in and say, amen, we need some glue this thing together. Any last and every day, we must hold it together. So, Lord, I have given unto your people that which you have given unto me.
Yes.
And I pray as they stand together as one, that nothing separate them. I pray that they able to stand the test of time.
Yes.
I pray that they can bind the devil.
Yes.
Amen. That he will flee from them. Resist and stand firm on the faith to know that all power is in your hand. Oh, he's loud. And that's all he has, amen. He's loud, amen. But no action behind him because, Lord, you're still in control. He wants to be, but Lord, you're still in control. So, Lord, help us. Help us to hold it together. Continue, Lord, to lift us up. Continue to take us high. Help us to be vigilant and sober-minded. Help us, Lord, to be alert, amen, to things that are around us. Amen. Teach us how to pray for our family members that are not saved. Teach us, how to treat one another. Help us be humble, Lord. Help us, Lord, amen, in this, amen, this time that we're in right now, Lord. Come, Lord, our goal is to make it to heaven. And maybe someone in your home may not be saved. We pray for them right now. Lord, touch their mind that they'll get saved. Touch their mind that they'll turn around. Touch their mind that they'll get together. Any last evil days, help us right here.
Yes.
forgive us in the wrong we've done. Amen. Anything that's breaking up the family home, Lord. Hey, take it out right now. Take it out right now. We bind that devil right now in the name. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We bind it in the name. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We bind the devil in the name of Jesus. And as we pray, Lord, we put that glue on it, Lord. That prayer, Lord, that when they go back home, bring their family together, Lord, that they can lay hands on, amen, hold hands, and then same prayer, Lord, amen. And we can pray, hey, Lord, help right now. Hey, as we pray, Lord, help us right now. Help us, that woman, Lord, that's trying to keep her family together. Help that man, Lord, that's trying to live right. Help that son trying to come out of that addiction. Help that young girl that don't know, amen. Lord, help her right now. Help the church, Lord, to stand any last evil day. Help, Lord, amen. The one that's trying to throw in the towel, Lord, but not give up right now. But just hold on to Jesus. God, the fifth of our faith. Jesus, help a writer. Oh, Jesus. Somebody needs you. Somebody need deliverance, Lord. Deliver the soul from the pits of hell. Deliver the mind. Somebody mind that's up. They say, never gonna be right. But Jesus, turn the mind. Jesus, move the devil. All problems, you're ready. Help! It's on the way! Help!
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a basket. Instead, they set it on a lampstand and it gives light to everyone in the house.